The criterion C assesses the extent to which critical thinking skills have been used to analyze and evaluate the research undertaken by the students, and it presents the criterion that has the most allocated marks. The term research refers to the literature sources, the primary and secondary sources, and the data gathered or collected by the students in the chemistry lab. Students should collect data and then analyze these data. Several methods can be adopted to present the data collected, like mathematical transformations, statistical analysis, tables, and graphs. Students should analyze their data in order to uncover trends and patterns that support and clarify the argument leading to the final conclusion. In this criterion, several components should be considered or taken into account by students. Knowledge and understanding-wise, the student should make sure that his content knowledge is accurate and trusted, and the source material adopted is pertinent and relevant to the research question, because any inaccurate info will affect the potential of good analysis to emerge. This also will be including answering the who, what, where, how, and why questions, and describe the methods that were used properly and accurately. On the application and analysis level, the student should show why did he choose this particular method. The student should also indicate any contradictions or other different points of view. Also, he must indicate any weaknesses in his approach. The uncertainties of the measurements should be evaluated and discussed. The student should develop mini analysis and micro conclusions at each point raised in his research work. For the synthesis and evaluation part, the original research question doesn't need to be fully answered by the investigation. In these cases, the student should point out unresolved issues and make suggestions as to how these might be further investigated. The things to avoid during EE writing. Students should avoid making or presenting evaluations that will be based on narrative or descriptive accounts. The student should not include any new info in his final conclusion. Also, he should avoid any personal opinion or unsupported claims. Students should not be presenting any conclusion that would be in contradiction with their argument presented. Students should not overlook any limitation related to the approach adopted. Now with the supervisor's role. The supervisor has several responsibilities. He should encourage and support the students throughout the research and writing of the EE, and he should provide the candidate with advice and guidance in the skills of undertaking research and ensure that the exam essay is the student's own work. The supervisor should assist students with the access to appropriate resources, such as people, library, chemistry lab, and also with the techniques of information and data gathering and analysis. The supervisor should also assist students with methods of acknowledging sources and by reading and commenting on the EE draft but not editing it. He should be monitoring the progress of the essay. The supervisor should ensure that the candidates are familiar with the assessment criteria, and he should explain the importance of avoiding a purely descriptive account. He should encourage students to find at least two or more different approaches to solving their research question. Encourage students to analyze secondary sources of data as well as their own experimental method. So, to summarize, students should show the relevance of the research. So, the data collected should be clearly relevant to the research question. On the level of analysis of research findings, the students must analyze the data collected to reach a reasoned argument. For the discussion and evaluation part, critical evaluation of the evidence is crucial, and the student must develop a reasoned argument supported by the evidence. Most of the candidates fail to consider more than one way of approaching the research question, and few candidates will discuss the decision that made them tackle the problem in a particular way. Most of students will usually try to adapt traditional methods, but only a few will try to apply a new approach. Another issue is that some students will rely only on secondary data and fail to show that a wide range of resources can be consulted. Some candidates will fail to clarify what was personal input from third-party procedures. Students should make it clear which experiments they have designed themselves and which they have altered, adapted, or improved from existing methods. They should also demonstrate that they understand the theory behind any techniques or apparatus used. As a checklist, the student should make sure he has answered all these questions. Has he made links between results, data collected, and the research question? If he included data or info that is not directly related to the research question, has he explained its importance? Are conclusions supported by the data presented? If he found unexpected info, has he discussed its importance? Has he provided a critical evaluation of the methods he selected? Has he considered the reliability of sources? Has he mentioned and evaluated the significance of possible errors that may have occurred in his research? Are all suggestions of errors or improvement relevant? In case it's possible, has he compared his results or findings with any other reliable sources? I hope this presentation was beneficial and looking forward to participate in more events contributing to this EE community. Thank you for your time.